6-foot senior from Sugar Grove, Illinois, Mo.
The Midwest Conference welcomes you to coverage of the 2020 Women's Midwest Conference Tournament on Midwest Conference Television and the Ripon Channel. Today's game is available through Stretch Internet through Midwest Conference TV at www.midwestconference.org and also available on your Roku, Apple TV, Android, or Amazon Fire TV streaming device. Starting lineups are presented by Choice Hotels Official Lodging, sponsor of the Midwest Conference. Now with today's starting lineups, here is Jason Mansmith.
Thank you very much, J.R. Thews, along with Riley Eisnagel on the executive producing and camera today. Let's take a look at your starting lineups first. For the Cornell Rams, they'll start number 11, Mo Kempiak. Number 15, Rose Shimoka. Number 25, Maya Johnson. Number 32, Bella Gonzalez. And number 44, Madison Waters. For Monmouth College, they'll start number 2, Caitlin Osmolski. Number 4, Yvonne Ornelis. Number 22, Carly Turnbull. Number 23, Jordan Kinty. And number 30, Michaela Seitz. First basket, it isn't good for 32, for Cornell, I should say. Number 11, that was Mo Kempiak on the basket for the Rams. Earlier here this evening, Ripon College victorious. And they will advance to the championship game to take on the winner of this game. Around to the outside edge, and a three-point shot on the way, put up and good. Three-point basket for number 3. Yvonne Ornelis on that three-point basket for the Monmouth Scots. And they lead 3-2 here. About a minute gone. Zone defense being played. Now they'll switch that out. 4 on the shot clock, on the basket, put up, no good. Rebounded out by Monmouth up the court. They will bring it. Pass down underneath, basket, no, the call charge. Monmouth 19-6 on the season. Cornell 15-9. The foul called on 32. Bella Gonzalez. I should say 22, Carly Turnbull. There we go. Around the outside edge, they'll work again. Do the Rams. Shot on the way, three-pointer is up and good. For Cornell. And behind the arc big time on that one.
three-point shootout tonight.
Bella Gonzalez with that three-pointer. Spin move and the kick back out. Shot up on the way and no good this time for Osmolski. Ornelas, I should say. Now the shot for three on the other edge, no good from Turnbull. She'll step back, shot off the glass and good.
Good follow-up on her shot.
Like I said, Michaela Seitz got the start for Monmouth, but I was wrong in that, being 32, Becca Gallis. Apologies on that. And around the edge, they'll work. Do the Rams. Back to the middle on the push. Shot on the way, deep, rebounded out by Gallis, and here comes Turnbull. Ornelas with a basketball on the right side edge, comes back to the middle. Throw back out on the top side. Now they'll find Ornelas in the corner, she'll reload. There's Turnbull, three-pointer. That one goes off the rim. Ornelas with the rebound. Turnbull was halfway down the court, didn't see it. Osmolski on the drive and a foul. No, ball goes out of bounds. Tied at 5, 6:54 remaining.
Monmouth seems to be making that extra pass to get their shooters open. They're just not going down right away.
Monmouth averaging 72 points per ball game. Cornell's 57. And in. Shot on the way is up and good. Three-point basket on the other side for Cornell. From Ann Visser. Osmolski with the dribble. Over to Turnbull. She'll get picked off and come to the other side. Cornell up with the shot. Basket off the glass. Too hard. Couldn't get the trailer saved. That's a turnover. Turnbull will go the other way. She's got the run out. Goes up hard off the glass. That won't go. She will get fouled, though, along the way. Picks herself up. She's okay.
Quick pace to start off the game, just like the last one.
And Turnbull will go to the free throw line. Carly misses the first one. 81% free throw shooter. She's shot 119 free throws this season. Gets to the line. Next one is not going to go either for her. Rebounded out by Visser. The work to the edge. Do the Rams. Now back inside. Turn around off the glass. That won't go. Rebounded back out. Throw to the outside edge. Three-pointer on the way. That won't go down either for Cornell. Ball out of bounds. And we'll stay with the Rams. Cornell under the head coaching direction of Brent Brzee in his 15th year. Brzee, I should say, my bad. And Kyle Wilson from Monmouth. Into the lane, they'll work. And a quick pass. And a turnover knocked out of bounds by Cornell. And Bella Gonzalez will back down to the other side of the court. Well, now this will hand off to Turnbull. Turnbull will come through, kick back out to the edge. Looking for Osmolski on the pass through. She'll get it. Another pass there, and basket up and good.
There's that extra pass I was talking about. Good setup.
Kinsey with that basket. Cornell leading 8-7 with 5:15 left in the first quarter. Rams looking to go inside on that. And we'll run it back out. Eight on the shot clock. Shot for three on the edge is long. Rebound comes out off of Monmouth. Backing into the game is 44 Madison Waters for Cornell. And Smith into the ball game now for the Scots. Turnbull will bring it up the court. Head to the right edge, foul to the left side. 7-8, Cornell leading by one. Shot on the way on the runner is good. Shane Smith on that basket for Monmouth to make it 9-8 with 4:23 remaining in the first quarter. Cornell set to take those jumpers on the perimeter and nothing but net on that one for Ann Visser.
Seems to be the game plan tonight is to take a lot of threes.
11-9 lead for Cornell. They've got the ball. Gonzalez will fight for it. Ornelas and Gonzalez on the possession arrow held ball. Cornell is a team shooting 29% from behind the arc on the season. They've taken 650 shots behind the arc compared to Monmouth, who shot 482 beyond the three-point line. Ornelas will go to the right side, find Smith. Cornell 3 of 6 behind the arc today. Monmouth 1 of 4, here's another one. Ornelas no good. And Monmouth on the defense will get blocked. Turnbull.
Clean block, nice block on the play.
Turnbull with the coast, she'll work around their defender and get the charge. So Carly Turnbull, the senior guard from Mason, Arizona, picks up her first foul. Second team for Monmouth. 11-9 Cornell leading, 3:22. Shimoka looking for some help, now finds Visser. Waters with the dribble, goes baseline against Turnbull, puts up the shot, tries to fight for it, and that's going to be another foul. That will not be on Carly Turnbull, that'll be on 23, Jordan Kinty. First personal, team's third. Waters for a first free throw is good. Extends that lead to 3 now for the Rams, 3:03 remaining. Next shot on the way, Waters, that's good as well. Back into the ball game, gonna be Maya Johnson, the 5'8 senior from Long Beach, California. And for Monmouth, number 3, Teray Warner. 3:02 left here in the first. Cornell with a 13-9 lead. Winner of this game will take on winner in the championship game tomorrow afternoon at 3 p.m. here at the Wilmore Center. Ornelas will get it back out to Warner, not on the corner. Shot for 3 from Warner is no good. Rebounded out, nice job there from Becca Gallis. I should say Jordan Kinty, my bad. Reverse the number. Spin move through the lane in the top. Here comes Gallis for 3. That won't go, rebounded back out by Smith. Quick passing around Monmouth. That shot won't go again, and another rebound offensively for the Scots, and that ball will roll out of bounds.
There is a lot of offensive rebounding going on this side of the court.
Kinty in the mix of that, and now the inbounds coming from Ornelas. They'll find Smith. 2:12 remaining in the first quarter, 13-9 lead for the Rams. Runner on the way, basket put up, no good. Gallis, and she goes down with an ankle. So, gonna walk that off. Oof. Feel for her. That's tough. That's tough. Carly Turnbull will come back in for Monmouth. As Becca Gallus takes a little rest. Got some cleanup here. Gotta get some of those end line sweepers out there for him. Ornelas will do the inbounds for the Scots, who trail by 4, 13-9. Turnbull squares up, basket won't go. Rebounded out of there by Bella Gonzalez.
The ball did a double doink there before it came out.
Now Ornelas a little bit hurt, and there's Ornelas 5-on-4. And Gonzalez with 3. And the coming out is going to be Ornelas. And in for Cornell, for Grinnell. I'll get it right. Monmouth, sorry guys. Warner coming through on the runner. Puts up the shot, no good. Josie Morgan checking in for Monmouth, and Warner will go to the free throw line. And Bella Gonzalez back in. Free throw from Warner is no good. 16-9, Cornell leading Monmouth here with a minute 35 left in the first. Warner on the next free throw. That's good. Makes it a 6-point lead now for the Rams. Maya Johnson will find Bella Gonzalez. Back to Rose Shimoka. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Waters will get the give and go. She'll work the... And against Turnbull, spin move left-handed, that won't go. Rebound fought out and knocked out of bounds by Cornell. Monmouth will get the 20-second reload. Coming in for Cornell, number 5, Madison Osborne. A minute left here in the first quarter, 16-10 Cornell. Good move around from Osborne, no good. Waters there, puts it up and back in.
Nice positioning on that, rebound and put back.
Waters with 4 points. And Cornell with an 8-point lead. Turnbull will come through. Good motion by the Scots. She'll get hooked. Double dribble. Okay, I thought she got held on the side a little bit there with the draw. Tis not the case. 18-10. 33.7 remaining. Here in the first. Osborne will get the screen from Gonzalez into Waters. Waters left-handed runner. Good. 10-point lead for Cornell.
Nice touch on that shot.
Monmouth will bring it up the court. Josie Morgan had it, dishes it off to Smith. Now back around to Warner with 3. She'll come through, put up the shot. That won't go at the buzzer. After one quarter complete, it is Cornell 20, Monmouth 10. We'll come back with the second quarter on Midwest Conference Television and the Ripon Channel right after this. Welcome back to the Wilmore Center on the Ripon College campus for the Midwest Conference Women's Basketball Tournament, second semifinal game. Cornell leading Monmouth after one quarter completes. Cornell shooting 44%, 7 of 16. And Monmouth just 4 of 14 for 27%. So the Cornell Rams, a little bit of a, on paper, 15-9 on the season. Monmouth coming in 19-6. Shot on the way, no good. And the ball out of bounds. That will stay with, I should say, that will go to Monmouth.
It is hard to keep up the pace of threes they're shooting, though. Eventually it catches up. But sometimes it works the whole game. We shall see.
Morgan on the quick dish to the side. There's Warner back through. Turnbull will go baseline with it, kick it back out, wide open three-pointer. That's good for Teray Warner.
Another nice extra pass on the offensive play.
Yeah, Warner shooting 53% behind the arc for the season. On the back out. 2013, Cornell with it. They'll go. Gonzalez looking for Waters. Waters will go. And I didn't see what they called, to be honest with you folks. Was it a travel? Okay. Okay. Apologize on that.
Thank you.
Morgan will go to the edge and look to find Smith. 20-13, 8:45 remaining. Turnbull's in the corner for a three. That'll come up short. Rebound by Cornell and a foul off it as well. Just a little bit too aggressive on the defense for Monmouth. Shane Smith will get that foul. Her first personal, team's first as well.
Monmouth seems to love that corner shot tonight. I wonder if Cornell will adjust to that.
Cornell will run and get the wall screen at the top of the key. Visser for three, that won't go. Rebound by Turnbull. 20-13, 8:15 left in the second quarter. Morgan on the drive to Warner. Now Smith on the left side of the lane. Warner trying to get that pass to Smith, and that covered up by Cornell, and a timeout quickly taken by the Rams.
Enjoy the action of Midwest Conference sports each season by logging on to www.midwestconference.org or by downloading the Midwest Conference app on your streaming device.
Well, thank you for that. Appreciate it.
Anytime, anytime. That's what I'm here for.
Anything else?
Well, once again, they have Monmouth passed into the corner.
Yeah. Working that edge. 20-13, 7:59 remaining on that timeout taken by Cornell on the trap. Rams will do the inbounds on the north end of the gymnasium here. A little discussion by the officials. I think we're set. All right, here we go. 20-13, Cornell with the 7-point lead. They'll work to the right edge. Madison Osborne running the point. She'll dish off and shot on the way, put up and good. For number 11, Mo Kempnick. Kempiak with that basket to make the score 22-13. Morgan to Turnbull. Turnbull to the right side, and she'll finish high. Nice move by Carly Turnbull. 22-15, 7:15 left. First half action. Kempiak hands off to Visser. Runner on the way from Ann Visser's no good. Rebounded out by Monmouth, and they'll go to the other side. Kinty with that rebound for the Scots will hand off to Turnbull. Warner loses the dribble, trips, and now a held ball, and possession will stay with Monmouth.
Seems the offensive pace has slowed down just a little bit here.
Since the second quarter began, it just seems like the foot off the gas just a little bit for these teams. Turnbull working the double team in the corner. The pressure back out and a shot clock violation. So Osmolski back into the ball game for the Scots. Shimoka will bring it up the court. Find Tara Hansel. Back to Shimoka. She'll step out for two, no good. Rebounded out by Gonzalez. Nine on the shot clock, they'll feed one down low. Try to scoop one underneath, hits the bottom of the rim. I don't know if Kempiak was actually trying to make the basket or just to hit the rim to get the shot clock reload.
That's a good point. I probably think she was probably trying to reset the shot clock.
Yeah, because she was so far underneath that. I just wondered if she just tossed it underneath to kind of get the rim to have the shot clock reload and get him a new 20 or what the story was on that. But
smart play.
Yeah, it was. This time she'll get a little separation and go up with it. No good, though. Rebounded out by Turnbull. Down to the corner, they'll work. Top side edge, here comes Turnbull. Three on the way, no good. Rebounded down by Maya Johnson. Another three on the other edge. Kempiak, that won't go. This time, Gonzalez puts up the shot. That won't go, and out of bounds off of Mondo. 22-15, Cornell leads 5-21. Levano Nellis back in for the Scots. Working around the outside edge. 10 on the shot. Kempiak with the basket, good.
Nice little spin move there for the bucket.
Cornell taking a 24-15 lead. Here comes Turnbull. She'll fight off the glass, no good. Basket put up, no good again for Monmouth. Turnbull will come away with it, throw to the right side. Shot off the glass, no good. On that run out from 12, Zoe Wall. Kempiak. Looking. Shimoka for the screen, gets it from Kempiak.
Good defense there in the corner.
Gonzalez will take one deep, no good. Rebounded out by the Scots. On the run out to the right side. Osmolski will hand it back for Nellis. Inside, shot put up, get blocked and fouled. Wall will go to the free throw line. That's gonna be number 11, Mo Kempiak. Cornell. Leading with 3:55 here in the second quarter. Free throw is good for Zoe Wall. the freshman from Peoria, Illinois, 6 foot freshman. That one will not go for Visser with the rebound. And Cornell with a 24-16 lead with 3:51. Winner of this game takes on Ripon tomorrow afternoon at 3 p.m. in the championship game with a chance to go to the NCAA. Not with a chance, with a guaranteed chance to get into the NCAA as the conference tournament winner. Out pass just a little bit over the head of Cornell and goes out of bounds in a turnover. Kinsey will come back in now for the Scots. And Monmouth will bring it back up. Nellis will find Smith, and they'll play catch. Wide open in the corner. Turnbull fights her way through. They'll call foul away, and now they'll call Maya Johnson for a foul. Second personal, second team for the Rams. Mom is sent to inbounds. They trail by 8. Smith is wide open, 3. That'll miss. Visser with the rundown. And ahead to Maya Johnson. Madison Osborne and the hand back to Visser. 24-16 lead for the Rams. Waters, she'll go left again. This time goes down and comes back out on the rim. 2:46 remaining second quarter. 8-point lead for the Rams. Smith with the screen at the edge. Shot through the middle of the lane, put up, no good. Turnbull had it, lost it. Jordan Kinty, I should say, on that rebound and lost it.
That would have been another offensive rebound for Monmouth. They're controlling the boards down on their end of the court.
24-16, 2:30 remaining. Ornelas got a pick. She'll go high on the finish. That won't go. Rebounded out and a foul. It's going to be on Ivani Ornelas. And Gonzalez back into the ball game. Down the court come the Rams. Visser high with the finish, no good. Rebounded out by Monmouth, and they are pulling boards like crazy in this game.
They just need to start converting some of these rebounds.
Shot is up and good, and the foul as well.
Right on cue.
Turnbull with the basket and the foul, 24-18 with a minute 50 left here. Shot on the way, Turnbull good. Quickly up the court comes Cornell on the run. That ball knocked out of bounds by Yvonne Ornelas. Some hustle going there. Shimoka back in. Kempiak as well. And the inbounds will come from Gonzalez to Waters. 24-19, Cornell leading by 6. 5. Shot on the way, basket put up and good from Shimoka. My math is not stellar tonight, folks. I will tell you. I'm better at talking than I am at adding today. So Ornelas will get the kick back out to Turnbull. Numbers are hard today. Just about a minute left here in this first half. Turnbull for three. Man, she's everywhere. Nice drive to the lane. Back up behind the three-point arc. Solid from the three-point, from the free throw line as well. And Monmouth is within four. 26-22. Shimoka put up the shot. No good. Rebounded out.
That's a nice drive. Just couldn't convert on the end of it. Wide open lane.
Kinty with that rebound. Ornelas will throw back as Molsky for a three. That one goes in and out. Rebounded Visser, hands it off to Shimoka. 23 seconds. Shot clock and game clock are pretty much even. Basket on the way from Kempiak, no good, but goes out of bounds and they'll talk. And that'll go to Monmouth with 14.3. Monmouth with a chance to get within one to go into halftime with a three-point basket here.
It came back pretty quick at the end of the quarter.
Tara Hansel back in for the Cornell Rams. Ornelas will come across the timeline. Look for Smith on the edge. 7 seconds on the screen. Osmolski. She'll come through. Big scoop underneath. Won't go. And that will be the end of the first half. It is Cornell 26 and Monmouth 22. For those of you watching on Midwest Conference Television, we'll be back in about 15 minutes. For those of you watching on the Ripon Channel, we'll be back right after this.
Total rebounds, 10 offensive leading rebounders include Jordan.
Welcome back as we get set to start the second half. Cornell leading Monmouth 26-22. Real quick look at those halftime statistics. We'll start with Monmouth shooting 27% for the game, 8 of 28, 3 of 13 behind the arc for 23%, and 43% from the free throw line. They're led by Carly Turnbull with 10 points, 4 points from Teray Warner, 3 points from Yvonne Ornelas, 2 points from Shane Smith, 2 from Jordan Kinty, and 1 from Zoe Walm. For Cornell, shooting 32%, 4 of 11 behind the arc for 36%, and 2 of 2 for the free throw line. They are led by a host of different players with 6. Mo Kempiak, Madison Waters, and Visser all with 6. Also Maya Johnson, Bella Gonzalez with 3 and 2 from Rose Shimoka. Rebounds, 23 for Monmouth, 20 for Cornell. 10 offensive rebounds for the Scots. Starting 5 back in for both teams. Shimoka with the dribble. They'll find Waters with 10 on the shot clock. She'll spin to the right side. That one won't go. Turnbull with the rebound.
It was a nice post-up of the defender on that shot. Just didn't go.
Ornelas will dish to the edge to Turnbull. She'll look for some help. Go to the right side as Molsky. Smith will come through on the reload. 3 from Osmolski, good.
1 point game.
26-25, 9:05 left in the third.
We'll see if Cornell keeps shooting the threes like they did in the first half. And if Monmouth can keep up their offensive rebounding.
Gonzalez to the right side. 7 on the shot clock as Shimoka comes through. Step back on the 3. That will not go. Rebounded out by Smith. Go to the other side. Smith on the left-handed finish and good.
Nice left-handed shot off the glass.
27-26, the first lead for Monmouth. Shot is put up, no good. Out of bounds.
Starting to get a little physical with some picks here.
Visser back into the ball game now for the Rams. The first lead of the ball game for Monmouth. Turnbull with just a really good presence when she's out on the floor. Controls that very well. Ornelas with the drive through. Basket put up, Kinsey, good.
Good pass in between the defense there, getting a shot by the basketball. By the rim.
29-26, 7:43. Picked off, Ornelas will come the other way. And drive to the right side, Turnbull with it. Smith comes through on the screen, blocked by Madison Waters. 29-26, Monmouth leads 7:15 remaining here in the third quarter. Shot on the way, put up. And going to the other side comes Yvonne Ornelas. Winner of this game takes on Ripon tomorrow afternoon. Gonzalez pushes ahead to Visser for a 3 on the run, no good. Rebounded out by Smith. Ripon with the victory earlier tonight over Knox. And the dribble through. And a foul called against 32, Bella Gonzalez. Hansel will check in now. ...29-26, Monmouth leading by 3. Onelis with the dribble and the kick back out to Smith. Turnbull this time with the left side lane, and she'll throw back out. Seven on the shot clock, three-pointer on the way. Smith, that'll bounce up, no good. Hits the retraction cable. Out of play. Looks like it went off the shot clock instead of the cable.
Monmouth was setting up there in the corner on the offense on this end of the court, too.
That shot put up and no good from Cornell. 6 minutes remaining here in the third, 29-26. Scots leads the Rams, picked off that one. Gonzalez, she'll go coast, left-handed finish and good. And a timeout taken by the Rams. 29-28, Cornell.
Great anticipation on that pass. Just intercepting it and going down and scoring the bucket.
7-2. Monmouth has outscored Cornell to start this. That basket coming right there, finally. Just about 4 minutes and 9 seconds, 4 minutes, 10 seconds away. After the start.
Monmouth has definitely found their defensive groove here.
Well, you hit a couple of shots too, it doesn't hurt. Gets the momentum going.
Exactly.
5:49 remaining in the third. Now set to inbounds. Looks like Josie Morgan checked in for the Scots. Shane Smith on the dribble. Turnbull works her way through, goes through all the defenders and gets fouled. Mo Campiak on the foul for the Rams, second personal for her. Second team, free throw, Turnbull rolls out, no good. Next one is good. 2-point lead for the Scots, 5:33 remaining. Quickly down the court for the Rams. Vissers in the handoff to Hansel. Three-pointer from the corner is good for Bella Gonzalez.
Nice pass, nice finish.
31-35, 07 remaining in the third. Turnbull again, she'll go baseline through two defenders, try to get one over to Ornelas and just touched out of bounds. Shamoka's coming back in. Maya Johnson back in. Madison Waters in for Cornell. ...31-30, Cornell leading. Shot for three, Ornelas won't go, rebounded out. Canty now, the kick from Morgan is good for a three. Josie Morgan, three-point basket is good.
I noticed on the inbounds that Cornell doesn't have anyone covering the inbounder.
Officials will chat. Discuss. All right. Not sure what the stoppage of play was about, but they'll have a little bit of pressure now from the Scots in the backcourt, and they'll break that press. Hansel with it, Monmouth with a 2-point lead with 4:31 remaining in the third here. Waters gets the feed. She'll work against Kinty, right-handed, that won't go.
Just keeping someone on her constantly every time she gets the ball, or someone there when she turns around.
Smith on the kick back out to Turnbull, she'll go to the edge. Good move from Turnbull. High on the finish. 35-31.
Off the glass again.
Just a quick little scoop move and was able to get the clear. 4-point lead now for the Scots. Visser at the free throw line. We'll look for Water. Waters will work it again and go to the line after foul from Jordan Kinsey. Monmouth is shooting 34% now in the game as Cornell sits at 29. Terrain Warner back in for Monmouth. Waters at the free throw line. Tosses off the rim, no good. Second free throw. That'll be a little strong as well. Smith will rebound it. And up the court comes Yvonne Ornelas. Terry Warner hands back to Shane Smith over to the right side. Ornelas for the three. That'll go. Makes it a 7-point lead now for the Scots, 3-14. Scott's a tough team. They've beat Ripon twice this season. Looking down just a tad bit too far, picked off and coming the other way is Smith. Turnbull with the basketball now to the side. Ornelas again, another three and another basket good. 10-point lead.
From the corner once again.
For the Monmouth Fighting Scots. And a timeout taken by Cornell as they trail by 10. 2:32 remaining here in this third quarter. And now another special announcement.
Enjoy the action of Midwest Conference sports each season by logging on to www.midwestconference.org or by downloading the Midwest Conference app on your streaming device.
So serious.
Once in a while, yes.
2:32 remaining here in the ballgame. A second half that's been very impressive for Monmouth, coming out with some good shooting. Defensively very well as well for them.
Lockdown on the defense. They still are playing from the corner.
All right, so Monmouth has outscored Cornell 19-5 here in the second half.
They have definitely taken control of the game.
Yeah, Cornell led this at halftime 26-22.
Had a big lead after the first quarter, too. So they slowly climbed back into it and now control the game.
And the inbound. Shot for three, no good. But the rebound put back up. And no good on that as the Scots bring it up the court, looking to extend their lead to beyond 10. Carly Turnbull. They'll work that offense, and she's able to cut through there just through the defenders, an easy finish.
Just taking it right in at them.
Now a foul off the ball. Turnbull with the foul. She's got 15 points in this game. 43-31 with a 1:58. Waters looking for some help. She'll work against Kinsey. Put up the shot and get it. Good position.
She backed in and made the shot off the glass.
Back to a 10-point lead. Smith will find Turnbull on the edge. They'll put two on her. Wide open the corner for three is Smith. No good. Warner runs it out. A little reset.
Good offensive rebound there.
Yeah, big time. Ornelas with it. Three-pointer from Warner. Good. Just when you think you have the control in the middle of the lane with Turnbull and those other players, they have that open wing. Buried shot.
They're very fast, too.
Their speed of play, pretty impressive.
You can tell the definitely tell the difference right now.
Under a minute to go, 46-33. 50 seconds left in the third. Kick back out, three on the way. Visser, that won't go. Comes off the right side of the rim. Saved by Kinsey, but she was out of bounds. All right, here comes the inbounds. Bella Gonzalez will do so. And find Ann Visser. And Visser will look back. Three on the way. Kempiak good for three. 46-36, 22 left here in the third quarter.
We're going to have to string a couple more of those together to get back into this.
Now they'll trap on the ball handler. Back over to Smith for three.
Back in Warner. The
another one.
From the corner.
After three quarters complete, it is Monmouth 49, Cornell 36. Fourth and final quarter back after this. You're watching Midwest Conference Television and the Ripon Channel. We start the fourth quarter with somebody advancing to the championship game tomorrow afternoon against Ripon here at the Wilmore Center. Monmouth leading Cornell 49-36. Big time scoring for Monmouth in that third quarter.
I believe Cornell only scored 8 points. In
10 points.
10 points?
Yeah.
Great defense by Monmouth.
27 for Monmouth in that third quarter.
Doing it on both ends.
Kempiak with the ball. Shimoka working. Waters just inside the free throw line with the mid-range. Good. 49-38. Monmouth leading Cornell. 9:24 left. Warner, who hit two big three-pointers. Here comes Ornelas for another three, no good. Waters will pull the rebound.
Looks like Monmouth is still going to try to attack with this lead.
There's Shimoka down into Madison Waters. Waters on the kick back out. Shot for a three from Maya Johnson. Is no good, but she'll go to the free throw line to shoot three.
I believe that's our first three shot foul tonight.
Correct. It's So she'll go to the charity stripe for a couple of tosses. Clean up in the middle there, so.
I should go down there and help.
Get on that, all right?
I'm on it.
Maya Johnson, an 80% free throw shooter, 8 of 10 on the season.
Then you probably just jinxed her. Let's see how this works.
It's the old broadcaster's jinx, right?
Don't mention the no-hitter.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so cleanup's taken care of. That one's on the way. Good.
80%.
Maya will get another one. Three bounces. Rotation. Good. And she'll get one more. 49-40. That one's a little strong. Rebounded out by Kinsey.
Brought it to single digits, though. We'll see if they can continue with the comeback.
8:43. Warner high on the finish. She'll dish it off instead. Coming through. They're calling for the charge. So Osmolski will come back in for Warner. And Madison Osborne coming in for Cornell. And now Monmouth will put some pressure on the inbounds. Gonzalez will dribble through, hand off to Osborne. Kempiak on the traveling violation.
That was a good move, but too many steps.
49-40, Monmouth leading Cornell with 8:22. Turnbull will come through, right side kick. Throw back inside, shot put up too hard from Kinsey. And Cornell with a chance to cut that lead just a little bit with a basket here.
Looks like the middle of the lane is open. If they can get somebody over there.
Johnson to Gonzalez, three. In and out, no good. Rebounded out by Smith.
That would have worked too. The middle was wide open there.
Ornelas to Carly Turnbull with the dribble. Travel. Osmolski, just too many steps on that drive. Tara Hansel back in. And Josie Morgan in for Monmouth. Shot high in the air, no good, rebounded out. And it rolls out of bounds. Kempiak with a high toss on that one. 7:07 remaining here in the fourth. 49-40, Monmouth leading Cornell. Turnbull will come through. Three in the corner, no good. They run that offense so effectively.
Another offensive rebound, too.
Ornelas will find Turnbull. Kinsey in the hand back. Down to the corner to Ornelas with five on the shot. Turnbull three. That won't go. Rebounded out by Hensel for the Rams. Osborne with the Jets on. Kempiak at the top.
They really need a basket here. and a really slow start to this quarter.
This time Gonzalez on the finish, can't get it to go.
Nice move though, that was very, very nice move. Just needs it to drop.
Morgan will run it out to Turnbull. Run on the way from Smith is no good. Cornell has outscored Monmouth 4-0 in this quarter, so scoring in this quarter has not been real prolific by any chance.
And you got the numbers right this time.
quick stats right in front of me this time, so.
Notice I don't say any numbers while we're on the air.
Yeah, well, you got your dig. Monmouth with 27 points in that third quarter, holding Cornell to just 10.
It's been quite a few traveling calls from both teams tonight.
49-45, 30 remaining. Winner taking on Ripon. Picked off Gonzalez.
Nice seal.
Yeah, that's a good foul. Yep. You got a little bit to give. She okay? Smith kind of come up holding up the midsection.
Kind of landed on her side. Was a good foul, but it was also a good steal and drive to the bucket.
Stopped that player from going in for the easy basket. It's only her second foul for Smith. Free throw, good.
And there hasn't been that many fouls in the fourth quarter yet, considering the score.
5:17 remaining, and the free throw is good. And Cornell has this within seven. And Terray Warner back in for the Scots. Yvonne Ornelas. Across the timeline, goes to the left edge, finds Carly Turnbull. Warner with 10 on the clock. Now gives to Ornelas. Shot from Turnbull, that's gonna go off the side, no good. And Kempiak up the court. That one bounces off, but a rebound comes out. Shot for three, no good. The ball out of bounds. On the men's tournament tonight, Ripon College knocking off Lake Forest 82-51, and St. Norbert victorious earlier, so the championship tomorrow. In De Pere will be Ripon versus St. Norbert. 49-42 with 4:29 remaining. You know what, I'm gonna challenge you, JR.
Yeah?
I got one more read on there, the legal one that I need you to take care of.
All right. This is
where if you're a Bill Schrader fan, he always gets this in the broadcast.
We're glad to have Bill Schrader back after his surgery too.
Yes, exactly.
Unauthorized use of today's broadcast on Midwest Conference women's basketball is prohibited without the express written consent of the Midwest Conference and the Ripon Channel.
Well done.
Thank you, sir.
No tavern of the game that we've got to introduce or anything like that. So.
I could name a business that we could give.
Right, exactly, right. 49-42, 4:25 remaining here in the fourth quarter.
See if some of these shots start dropping for these teams.
Monmouth in control. Turnbull almost lost the dribble. Here's Ornelas for a three. Uh-oh, got it. Back to a 10-point lead and 4 minutes left. Roshimoka. Trying to find Gonzalez and does though. Over to Visser. Kempiak will go baseline. Create some separation, that just won't go for. Rebounded out by Kinsey.
finally stopping those offensive rebounds.
Shot on the way, basket up and good for Monmouth.
See if Cornell can get an answer here.
12-point lead for the Scots with 3:20 remaining. Visser and Morgan fighting in the lane. Here comes Water for three, no good. Warner with the rebound for the Scots, and they'll run the other way. Terrell Warner with 10 points tonight for the Scots. Turnbull will kick it back out. Good pass, the extra one coming through. And they'll find another one. Kinsey goes up and gets fouled. That'll be Cornell's first foul of the fourth quarter.
That was their first foul in the fourth quarter?
Correct.
That's
pretty clean
impressive.
Play.
Yeah, that's impressive. Oh, let's see what they can do with them. The free shots.
Kinsey. That one's a little strong. Kinsey doesn't waste time at the free throw line. I think one dribble and a spin. Two, okay. Firing away, good. And a timeout taken by the Scots. 30-second timeout. Fourth quarter here, 55-42. I want to thank you all for joining us. A big thanks to our executive producer and cameraman tonight, Riley Eisnagel, for his help. Bringing you the action.
Monmouth ran a little bit there. Scored pretty quickly on Cornell.
Yeah. Got to get some stops, and you got some fouls to... You can get some stops because you've still got four fouls to go before you're in the bonus here. So you can burn down some of this clock pretty quickly if you wanted to.
Well, let's see what they decide to do. 2:50 left. And like you said, four fouls to give.
So Bella Gonzalez will do the inbounds on the baseline. And finds Osborne with it. Kempiak will look against Turnbull. That one tipped out of the way from Terrell Warner. And the inbounds will come from Gonzalez. .234 remaining. 55-42, Monmouth lead. Three on the way. Good! Van Visser.
That was clean, nothing but the bottom of the net.
Quick timeout taken by Cornell. They still have one timeout left after this one. Tomorrow afternoon, the championship game featuring Ripon and the winner of this game. That is a 3 p.m. tip-off here from the Johnson Gillespie Court inside the Weiske Gymnasium at the Wilmore Center on the Ripon College campus. In Ripon, Wisconsin. Had to add that, right?
Definitely.
For going through the rundown of all the places we're at in Fond du Lac County.
Wisconsin, United States.
Right. Continents
the
of
world,
North America.
Outer space. The Milky Way.
Right. 10-point lead for the Monmouth Fighting Scots over the Cornell Rams.
10 points, fourth quarter, 2:26, still possible.
Yeah, we'll see if we see some of these fouls coming in here to get some quick stops. Warner will go with it, and a big step around. Easy basket for two.
Based on that, I would say right now, no.
Turnaround jumper on the way, put up, that won't go. Now we'll have a foul away from the ball. Looks like Kempiak's going to get away for a push. That'll be her third. Second team. Ornelas will work around. Morgan with a crossover.
Almost an ankle breaker on that one.
Turnbull goes behind the back. Kick to the edge, three on the way. Warner comes up short, rebounded out by Gonzalez down to Kempiak. Minute 38, 57, 45. Nice move around, just won't go.
Good rebound.
Three on the way, Visser. That'll hit front of the rim. Rebound comes down to Shane Smith with a minute 25 remaining. This is where you gotta leave it all out there with the last minute 18. Good screen coming away from Ornelas. We'll have a foul away and underneath. Blocking foul called against the Rams.
I'm starting to think that's a little too late for that.
Yeah, Rose Shimoka with the foul.
Still two more. They have two more fouls yet. Well, the second one will be a shooting foul.
Ornelas will do the inbounds. Warner back out to Morgan. Down to the corner, good move around. And now the quick foul to stop the clock. That's her third, team's fourth. And the inbounds. Turnbull will get her another foul, and that'll be the team's fifth, so now we'll go to the line.
See if she can make these. She does. I don't know.
Yeah, it's a tough.
Yeah.
Tough road to come back from when you're up with 12, possibly 14 here in this game.
Especially only a minute three to go.
First one, no good. Second one on the way. That one is good. So the inbounds. Here comes Cornell. Run on the way up is good, no. Rebounded back out. Gonzalez will go with the fight, under 50 seconds to go. And a quick foul there.
Looks like the refs were just letting them play on that offensive possession.
Right. So Visser will get the first. And Carly Turnbull will go to the free throw line. For two. First one's up, no good. So, second one, good. Turnbull makes it a 59-45 lead with 45 seconds. Outside of a miracle. Cornell has said, okay, we'll let this play out the way it is. Nice end of the season hugs from the team. And the championship game tomorrow will be the Ripon College Red Hawks taking on the Monmouth Fighting Scots, the 1-2 seeds in the tournament. Much like the men who have the 1-2 seeds going into the championship game tomorrow as well. Now a quick foul. So we'll have that coverage tomorrow afternoon here on Midwest Conference Television.
Should be an interesting game.
Yeah, hope you can join us.
Height against speed.
Yeah, exactly. You have to remember, Monmouth beat Ripon twice this year. And it's that third game is always just
hard to beat them three times.
Yeah, exactly.
In
but we'll see.
Yeah.
Monmouth.
Everyone's got to tune in and see if they can do three.
Yeah. Monmouth coming in, averaging 72 points a ball game. So a little bit under that today, but that basket is good.
Cornell started really well, they just couldn't maintain.
That 27-point third quarter for Monmouth, the key for the Fighting Scots. Checking a few more players in now for Monmouth. Taking a look at those end of game statistics, Monmouth shooting 40%, 21 of 52. And Cornell shooting 26%, 16 of 62. Charlie Turnbull leading scorer, 17 amongst them both. Basket put up from Mo Kempiak. Good for two, gives her 11 to take the leading scorer for Cornell. Under 10 seconds to go here. They'll just let this one run out. And Monmouth will head to the championship game to take on the Ripon College Red Hawks coming up tomorrow afternoon. Want to thank you all so much for joining us here. The Midwest Conference, thank you for watching coverage of the 2020 Women's Wisconsin, I should say Women's Midwest Conference tournaments on Midwest Conference Television and the Ripon Channel. Today's broadcast is made available by Stretch Internet through the Midwest Conference at www.midwestconference.org. Join us next time for more exciting action from the Midwest Conference here on Midwest Conference Television and the Ripon Channel. For Riley Eisnagle, J.R. Thews, I'm Jason Mansmith. Have yourself a great night, everybody. Thank you.